Now, before we get started building our own things, I'd like to show you a very important concept and ask you to follow along in case you're able to do on your environment. I'm going to explain soon. Let's first close this app. So I'm going to click on back and click on leave, and this will close my app since it's already saved. Okay, then it shows this pop-up. I just click on leave. And let's go to the home screen of Power Apps to make.powerapps.com. Here I want to show you a concept that's called environment. In the top here we see environment, and in my case it shows Rudimar Power Apps. That would be my company in my case. And between parentheses it's written default. This is the place where everyone can build app on your organization. But we could have other environments. Here we are seeing some other environments that I created for other situations or other lessons. And what this means is that if I go to another environment, maybe you don't have other environments here, I can see other apps in here and not the apps that I have on my default environment. They are loading, but soon they are going to appear, and see, they are very different apps. This is a way for the company to separate environments. They could, for example, create an environment for the legal department, another for the human resources, another for the field users, and so on, and separate apps. In professional app development, we usually have three environments, one for development, one for tests, and one for production. It's not our case, but it's good to know that this exists, because in case you build a very nice app in the future, your company may have these policies that they have separate environments, and you may want to migrate that. And you may need to migrate that to another environment. And this is done using solutions. Here in the left, we have this called solutions. A solution is like a package, it's like a bucket that we can put everything inside. Tables, apps, flows, and other things that the platform have. The good practice is always to create a solution and develop your things inside the solution. Let me go back to my default environment and I will go to solutions. Now I can click on new solution and give it a name. So in this case, I will call Power Apps Building Blocks. Okay, and then I select a publisher. A publisher represents who created this solution. In my case, I already created mine called RBA Digital. But if you don't have one, we have these default ones, but we can create our own publisher that represents who we are. So if we click on new publisher, provide the information here, for example, display name, in my case, RBA Digital, also the name. The name should not have spaces. It will give me a prefix. So in this case, I will call RBA. This prefix is this first letter that will appear in front of all the objects that I create, apps, flows, and so on, to identify who created. And then click on save. You could also provide contact information if you want, but it's not required. Once you click on save, then you will be able to find our publisher here and select and then create the solution. Now it's creating, it will open here and we will understand what it is. Here the solution is opened and we see here in the left pane that we have apps, cards, chatbots, cloud flows, tables, and so on. It's all with zeros, it means the solution is empty, but we can add things in here. For example, if we are going to create an app from scratch, we can go to new app and select canvas app. Or if you are going to work with automation, creating a Power Automate, you can go to new automation, cloud flow, and select the type of flow, and so on. If you already have an app that was created outside the solution, we can bring to the solution, going to add existing app, canvas app, and it will show the apps that I have in here, in this case, outside Dataverse, and my apps called Power Apps Learning App. Then I can click on Add, it will appear inside the solution. Let's click on Add and see how it works. I'm adding the app to the solution. Soon, this panel will disappear and the app will be here. The app's now here, but the problem is that sometimes we cannot do that. We cannot add something that was created outside the solution to a solution. And in the case we need to migrate, that's very complex. Sometimes we may need to rebuild. So if you have the possibility to create it, just go and create yours. We are not going to go very deep in this concept, but it's good to have the first contact and know that this is something important. Imagine that I wanted to export and import in another place, then I could go to export solution, and here there is the process to export, and in the other environment I could import. That's beyond the scope of this course, because this starts to get more advanced, and we are citizen developers, we are going to build small apps for our productivity. We don't need to know this at this moment. Okay, now I can go open the solution, and here's my app. If you cannot create a solution, don't worry, you can do your app outside the solution, but if you can create, I strongly advise to do that. Now, in the next lessons, we are going to get starting learning how to build things inside the Canvas app. See you there.